Here's a story you may not have seen. In our solar system, there has been an object the size of Manhattan called Atlas 3I passing through. A lot of experts think it's a big comet, but that may not be the case. Harvard's top guy on this joins us, Dr. Avi Loeb. What else could this be?
Well, thanks for having me. I'm joining you from the Harvard College Observatory. Behind me, there is a telescope that is nearly 200 years old. Well, it could be that it was sent by some intelligent civilization elsewhere in the Milky Way galaxy. You know, the fundamental question is whether Elon Musk was the most accomplished space entrepreneur since the Big Bang, 13.8 billion years ago. And there are so many stars out there, 100 billion of them, and they, many of them, 10% or so, have a planet the size of the Earth, roughly at the same separation. So, you know, in our cosmic neighborhood, there could have been many technologies like us a long time ago, billions of years ago. And so the question is, are they out there? And the best way to find out is to check for any spacecraft that may enter the solar system from outside. And lo and behold, there was a big object the size of Manhattan that was spotted on July 1st this year. It's moving in the plane of the planets as if it wanted to have a reconnaissance mission towards the planet. And it just passed the sun. It had some non-gravitational acceleration, meaning that there was some force acting on it in addition to gravity. And it looks really weird. There are several anomalies that I spotted, 12 of them, that make it unusual, unlike the comets that we're familiar with.
And so when you talk about these anomalies and non-gravitational movement, the argument, and you write a lot about this on your blog, is that you think it's possible this big Manhattan-sized object could have, like, a thruster on it.
Right. We do see seven jets coming from it. Some are directed at the sun and some are pointed away from the sun. And it's not clear what is the origin of these jets. And one possibility is that it's pockets of ice on the surface of a rock. But another is that these are thrusters. And, you know, they go a million kilometers in all directions. And, you know, that's quite unusual. And the good news is that we can collect a lot of data in the coming weeks. It will get closest to Earth on December 19th, about a week before the holidays. And let's just hope that it will not send any unwanted gifts to Earth.
And so when you talk about unwanted gifts, what you're basically describing is like a mothership with probes, potentially. What would some other civilization want here on Earth or with us Earthlings?
Well, it's hard to tell, right? Because it's a blind date of interstellar proportions. And my advice on a blind date, and by the way, I met my wife on a blind date, is that you should observe the other side before having an opinion. And all I'm asking, you know, the foundation of science is the humility to learn. It's not the arrogance of expertise, the way that most academics brag. You know, it's we should use it as an opportunity to learn of what lies beyond the solar system.
And should people watching this, who are just hearing about Atlas 3I for the first time, be worried?
Not at this time. I would think that based on the data we have, most likely it's a natural comet. However, there is some significant anomalies that accompany it. And as a result, you know, it could be a black swan event. We all know about the Trojan horse story, where the residents of the city of Troy welcomed something that looked completely innocent. So in a black swan event, you better take seriously the potential risks and monitor the visitor. And that's my hope. That's what I'm advocating for. And actually, NASA is supposed to release a high-resolution image of this object when it came very close to Mars on October 3rd this year. It was within 29 million kilometers. You know, the United States has a lot of stars on its flag. And my point is that the United States should not just be a beacon of light to all nations on Earth. It should be a beacon of light to all civilizations in the Milky Way galaxy. And so, you know, we should explore space, lead the way for humanity to figure out what lies out there.
And based on what you were describing, this could soon be the biggest story in the world, literally the biggest story in the universe. And so, Dr. Loeb, thank you so much for being here. Depending on what these NASA pictures show, we might have to have you back soon.
Thank you. I'll be delighted to join you.
All right. Much appreciated.
Hey, it's Will Cain. Click here to subscribe to the Fox News Channel on YouTube. It's the best way to get our latest interviews and highlights. And click to subscribe to the Will Cain podcast for full episodes right now.